Have you ever felt the need to get somewhere really quickly? Would Mach 17 work? That's the top speed at which a new prototype engine developed by researchers at the University of Central Florida might potentially hurl an aircraft through the skies, making a trip from Los Angeles to New York in under half an hour. At the heart of this new technology is a new propulsion system that stabilizes detonations and then uses their shockwaves to deliver hypersonic thrust to an aircraft. Sounds like something out of a sci-fi movie, doesn't it? In today's video, we will be taking a deep dive into how UCF researchers are building this new technology that could make interplanetary travel easier. UCF researchers say they have trapped a sustained explosive detonation, fixed in place for the first time ever. They have finally figured out how to channel its enormous power into thrust in a new oblique wave detonation engine. This could propel an aircraft up to 17 times the speed of sound, potentially beating the scramjet as a hypersonic propulsion method. The new technology will allow jets to achieve speeds of up to Mach 17 without releasing an out-of-control detonation. Explosions in propulsion systems are nothing new. They've been used to move pistons in ICEs, or internal combustion engines, for almost 150 years. The combustion process used by ICEs is known as deflagration. Deflagration, the high-temperature burning of fuel with oxygen, is a relatively safe, slow, and controlled way to release chemical energy and turn it into motion. This technique is similar to how a fire burns in a fireplace. That's exactly why this nice, peaceful form of combustion supports so much of our transport technology. But you need to extract the most possible energy from a unit of fuel to get the best bang for your buck. Detonation, on the other hand, is a much more violent sort of combustion. It is a quick, chaotic, and often destructive process. It doesn't really require oxygen. All it takes is a single explosive material and an energy thrust large enough to break the chemical bonds that keep an already unstable molecule together. It generates exothermic shockwaves that travel at supersonic speeds outwards, releasing massive amounts of energies. Detonation spreads supersonically, and the fuel used to power it can be destroyed extremely quickly. They're also far more difficult to regulate and are much more harmful than traditional deflagration reactions. But there are some benefits to using such a strong reaction to generate thrust. For more than 60 years, people have been trying to harness the raw power of detonation, the most intense kind of combustion. But putting a bridle on a bomb has proven incredibly difficult. In the beginning, there were pulse detonation engines, which created a series of repeated explosions similar to a pulse jet. Various teams have worked on these types of engines, and they have already been tested in airplanes, most notably in the Scaled Composites Long EZ Borealis project, which was created by the US Air Force Research Laboratory back in 2008. Next, there were rotating detonation engines, in which the shockwaves from one detonation were tuned to trigger further detonations in a ring-shaped channel. They have to play off one another, with each pushing the exhaust a little bit faster until it reaches hypersonic speeds. This demands precise placement of each detonation, and often results in brief short test runs that last only a few milliseconds, making it impractical to use in a commercial system. Rotating detonation engines should be more effective than pulse detonation engines simply because the combustion chamber does not need to be cleared out between detonations. They were thought of as impossible to build right up until the researchers at UCF went ahead and presented a prototype last year in sustained operation. Some of the team members announced that they had successfully tested an engine based on this concept. In their experiment, they carefully controlled the rate at which the fuel was fed into the engine, and the concept is due for testing in a rocket launch by around 2025. Now they have taken that research one step forward. Another team from UCF, including some of the same researchers that worked on the rotating detonation engine last year, says it's managed a world's first demonstration of an elusive third type of detonation engine that could outpunch them all, theoretically opening up a pathway to aircraft flying at speeds of up to 13,000 miles per hour, or 17 times the speed of sound. This new sort of detonation, called the oblique detonation wave, is stationary and is stable for at least a few seconds. This makes them much more practical for use in a real system, and it solves many of the problems with the rotating detonation engine they had previously designed. The method uses the power of the oblique detonation wave, which is created by using an inclined ramp inside the reaction chamber to generate a detonation-inducing shockwave for propulsion. In their latest research published in the Journal Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, the researchers developed a means to stabilize the detonation by building a special hypersonic reaction chamber for jet engines. The standing wave, also known as the oblique wave detonation engines, aims to create a fixed, in-space, continuous detonation, resulting in a ruthlessly efficient and controllable propulsion system that generates significantly more power and uses significantly less fuel than current technology allows. The UCF team claims it has successfully controlled the detonation wave under hypersonic flow conditions, keeping it in place rather than having it move upstream where it could cause the fuel source to explode, or downstream where it could lose its explosive advantage and fizzle out into a deflagration. Since the main problem that made detonations difficult to study was its short duration, the UCF researchers created a new hypersonic reaction chamber known as a hypersonic high enthalpy reaction, or hyperreact facility, which allowed them to increase the time period of the detonation wave. The facility contains a chamber with a 30-degree angle ramp near the propellant mixing chamber that stabilizes the oblique detonation wave for 3 seconds in a controlled experiment. This has never been done before, because previous work only captured it for milliseconds. This carefully controlled approach uses detonation as a power source that could let a jet travel at speeds of Mach 6 to 17, which is more than 4,600 to 13,000 miles per hour, while stopping the powerful shock that could damage the craft's surroundings. Oblique detonation waves, unlike rotating detonation waves that spin, are stationary and stabilized. The technology increases the efficiency of jet propulsion engines, allowing them to generate greater power while using less fuel than a traditional propulsion engine, thus lightening the fuel load and reducing emissions and costs. In addition to faster air travel, the technique could also be used in rockets for space missions to make them lighter by requiring less fuel, burn more cleanly, and travel farther. The ability of stabilizing a detonation has the potential to transform the future of energy systems and hypersonic propulsions. Ahmed, professor in UCF's Department of Mechanical and Aerospace Engineering, said that this is the first time a detonation has been shown to be stabilized experimentally. "We are finally able to hold in the detonation in space in oblique detonation form. It's almost like freezing an intense explosion in physical space," he said. In 1976, a Lockheed SR-71 Blackbird hit 2,193 miles per hour, or 3.3 times the speed of sound, at its high-flying altitude, setting a new record for a manned air-breathing plane. Hypersonic speeds, more than 5 times the speed of sound, have been achieved by rocket-powered jets, with one manned experimental aircraft hitting 4,520 miles per hour over the Mojave Desert in 1967. Unmanned aircraft and rockets have gone even faster. In 2005, a NASA experimental plane reached Mach 9.6. But that's not all. Humans have the ability to withstand even faster speeds. The Apollo 10 spacecraft, for example, hit 24,816 miles per hour upon re-entry into the atmosphere in 1968. But that kind of velocity cannot yet be maintained in a controlled, safe, and comfortable environment. The engineers at UCF believe that their system could one day provide a highly precise flow of energy, allowing hypersonic travel to become more feasible. The next steps will include adding new diagnostics and measurement techniques to obtain a better grasp of the phenomena they are studying. The method is currently being studied on a small scale. As we mentioned earlier, the apparatus that feeds and detonates the hydrogen and air is only around 2 by 2 inches in size. The researchers want to test their explosion system on a bigger scale in the future, first on the ground and then in a test flight, with the goal of commercializing it for use on land or in space. But first, they say they will continue to experiment with different flight parameters in the experimental setting, simulating how their system would react when a plane is climbing, landing, or descending on a runway. What does it all mean? Well, hypersonic air travel at speeds of up to Mach 17 will not just open the door to potential sub-30-minute trips between Los Angeles and New York, it will also make it possible for space planes to efficiently fly themselves right up into orbit without strapping themselves to rocket boosters. If successful in advancing this science, detonation-based hypersonic propulsion could be implemented into human atmospheric and space travel in the coming decades. But the engine is still far from being ready for commercial use. If it is further developed, it has the potential to save a large amount of money on gasoline, with some estimates putting the savings up to 25%. It could also be used to power much faster rockets and planes that are currently available. Just don't expect to see them in your car anytime soon. Any regulatory organization worth its salt is unlikely to give a supersonic car the green light. Are you excited to blast off in planes at hypersonic speeds? Let us know in the comments, and don't forget to like the video. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next one.